नेक्स्ट इज ड्रेनेज. द ड्रेन्स वेर मेड ऑफ बेक्ड और किन फिल्ड ब्रिक्स. सो एज यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर द ड्रेनेज सिस्टम वॉज मेड अप ऑफ बर्न ब्रिक्स. ओके. द किचन्स एंड द बाथरूम हैड ड्रेन लीडिंग आउट इन द एलीज. सो दिस ड्रेन सिस्टम वॉज कनेक्टेड टू द किचन एंड बाथरूम वेर द डर्टी वाटर्स आर कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम ईच हाउसेस. The main drain ran alongside the main roads and was lined with bricks. So, all these drains were connected to a main drain system where all the waters from each houses were collected and they were thrown out from the whole civilization. Most of them were covered with slab of stone. So, even these drains in most of the places, they were covered with a stone slab so that no you can say different types of mosquitoes can accumulate here and spread different diseases. The drains were cleaned periodically. So during the Indus Valley civilization, they used to clean their drains periodically, maybe after you can say a week, a month, or 2 months or so on. They were connected to the main drains in the street. So we have already discussed that each drains which are coming from each houses, they were connected to a main street. Next, occupation. What was their occupation through which they used to earn their livelihood? Then these people were farmers, weavers, potters, metal workers, toy makers, jewelers, stone cutters and traders. So in the Indus Valley civilization, there was a varieties of people who used to do different types of different occupations. Okay, so they were farmers who used to do the agriculture, some were weavers who used to make different types of, you can say, cotton they used to make different types of items, maybe pillow and so on. Potters who used to make different types of potteries, metal workers who used to make different types of tools, utensils, weapons. Okay, toy makers was also there who used to make toys for the children of the Indus people. Some were jewelers who used to make different types of jewelries which were worn by both the men and women of the Indus Valley civilization. Stone cutters, some were the person who used to cut the stone and they used to make different types of items. Maybe you can say a statue or a tools or you can say different types of design which they used to make in the stones. Okay, and some were traders, that means who used to sell the items in other outside their civilization. Okay, as you can see in this, in picture A, these are the toys which were made by the Indus people for the children's, and these are the potteries which were made by the Indus people. Agriculture was the most important occupation because of the fertile soil. So as we have already discussed that each civilization during those time, they used to flourish near the water bodies. Okay, so that's why their main occupation was agriculture. Why? Because the soil was very fertile because of the water. Farmers cultivated two crops a year. So every year they used to cultivate two types of crops. Indus Valley people were probably the first to have grown paddy. So we can say that the people belongs to the Indus Valley civilization, they were the first person who had grown the paddy. They knew different methods of irrigation and used plough and sickle. So during this period, they have learned the different techniques of irrigation. Okay, and by using the different types of ploughs and sickles, they used to do the agriculture. The Indus people were also engaged in hunting, fishing and gathering fruits. So they were also engaged in hunting the animals, catching the fish and gathering fruits from the nearby jungles. The potter's wheel was commonly used. So the potter's wheel was commonly used so that they can make different types of potteries, making terracotta toys, statues, figures of animals, etc. was a major industry. So these are the things which they used to make during their period. Here is a dancing girl, which is the famous statue which was excavated from the Indus Valley civilization. The discovery of the bronze statue of a dancing girl indicates that they knew the use of bronze. So this statue was made up of the metal known as bronze, and with the help of this statue we came to know that During the Indus Valley civilization, the people, they knew how to use bronze. It is regarded as one of the finest artistic creation of this civilization. So dancing girl, this statue is regarded as the one of the finest architect creation of the Indus Valley civilization. Seal making, they used to make different types of seals. A large number of seals, approximately 2000, have been unearthed so far at different sites. So from the different you can say sites of the Indus Valley civilization, around 2000 seals are excavated or discovered. They are flat, square and rectangular and are made of terracottas. So they are either flat or in square shape or rectangular and are made of terracotta. Terracotta is a kind of materials which they used to make during the Indus Valley civilization. They provide a lot of information about the daily life of the people, their religion, occupation, customs and trade. So with the help of these seals, we came to know what was their day-to-day activities of the Indus Valley people, what was their religion, what was their occupation, which is agriculture, what was their customs and how they used to do different types of trade. Probably they were used by merchants and traders to stamp their goods. So these seals were used by the merchants who used to make the different types of cloths and on large scale, and traders who used to sell these items outside their civilization. So they used to use this seal in order to stamp their goods. That means if they stamp this seal in their goods, this proved that these items belongs to the Indus Valley civilization. Here are the important seals which were excavated from the different sites of the Indus Valley civilization. As you can see, they have made the seals in different structure, okay, and each seal plays an important role and tell us about their daily life of the people, their religion, their occupation, their customs, their rituals and their trade, or you can say their business. Next is spinning and weaving. The Indus people were skilled in the art of spinning and weaving, which we have already discussed. They manufacture woolen clothes from the sheep and goat's hair. So they used to manufacture woolen clothes from where? From the sheep and the goat's hair. Trade. The Indus people had engaged themselves in inland and foreign trade. So they not only do the business in the nearby surrounding of the Indus Valley civilization, but also the foreign trade. That means different countries, or you can say different civilization. Remains of a dockyard discovered at Lothal in Gujarat clearly indicate this. So different types of items which were found in the dockyard of the Lothal, which is present in Gujarat, and it was the part of the Indus Valley civilization, clearly indicates that they used to do business from other civilization. This dockyard might have been the place where ships were loaded and unloaded. So this Lothal is a place which is present in Gujarat. From these place, we came to know that these places were used to load different types of items from the Indus civilization, and they used to sell in the other civilization, and even they used to bring different types of items which they do not make in their area. They used to bring that in their place, and they used to use in their day-to-day activities. Thus, we can say that Indus people were familiar with ship. So hence we can say that Indus people, they know how to use the ships. Indus seals have been found in Mesopotamia. So Indus seals have been found in Mesopotamia. So hence we can say that they have a trade relation with the Mesopotamia. Mesopotamian seals have also been found at several Indus cities. So in the sites. So different types of Mesopotamia seals have also found in different Indus cities. So it clearly shows that in Mesopotamia civilization and Indus Valley civilization, they both used to have their trade business with each other. It suggests that the Indus people had trade relation with the Mesopotamia. The merchants also use various kind of weight and measures. So the merchants, they used to use different types of weights and measures so that they can do the business in a proper way. As you can see in this picture, some of the objects that were used by people to weigh and measure the various articles of trade. So with the help of these items, they used to measure the weight of the item and they used to do the business.